Vamos con Pete Reyes, jefe de ingenieros del proyecto de la nueva Ford 150 2015.
Well, I'm here with Pete Reyes, chief program engineer for the brand new Ford 150, the most successful vehicle in the auto industry, right?
That's absolutely right, Javier.
37 years running?
37 years running, and with this truck, it's going to keep its leadership for a long time.
So I'm not going to do too much justice to you, because I know you've been working for at least 4 years in this program, and we only have like 10 minutes, so we're going to have to be so quickly on this level. I mean, an amazing program. We just went through five, six, seven, eight different demonstrations here at the launch of this event here in San Antonio, Texas, and it's fantastic. Now we're standing at probably what it's the most talked about thing in the car, right? Like the aluminum body of it.
Yep, we're right here next to a cutaway of the aluminum body. It's the body, the box, and the front end. And as you mentioned, it's the most important thing to talk about because it's a breakthrough to put this much aluminum on a vehicle like this. But the real breakthrough is what the customer gets. The customer gets a vehicle that's better at everything. When you're 700 pounds lighter, it steers more nimbly, it handles better, it does better on durability, it brakes quicker, it accelerates faster, and it can carry more load. So we're here in the lab, but today you also drove it. So
yeah. I mean, absolutely true. And when I mentioned about this is the most talk about part of it, because there's been some talk and some people are doubting about like, oh, really, are you going to put aluminum in a pickup truck, in a working vehicle? I mean, but this is really, you have tested this like to the death.
Yeah, and it's a legitimate proposition. You know, Class 8 trucks have used aluminum on steel frames back when there were strict weight laws, so that they could carry the most cargo they could in their semi-tractor trailers since 1939. The military uses 6000 series aluminum, which is aluminum you can heat treat for half an hour or 5 hours to get really strong. Airlines use it. So what we're picking up here is not the aluminum you see around your house, but it's a grade of aluminum that the military uses, and that when you apply heat to it becomes really, really strong. With the strength and the gauge, it can approach high strength steels.
Yeah, but the fact that no other manufacturer has used it for a pickup truck, it's for a reason, right? I mean, like, it takes more work, more money to develop it and all those kind of things,
yeah,
I guess, right?
You know, you're starting to see aluminum on cars, Land Rover.
Yeah, but luxury vehicles, pretty much.
Land Rover is an SUV that's gone aluminum. So aluminum was on its way. I think we were just the leaders and took the first step in what's a logical next step. Full-size pickup trucks, America needs them. They build America. They have to be more efficient. We've got efficient powertrains. We've got efficient chassis. Now it's time to make the body weight efficient. And you're right. It is a very big step. The important part is the body shop that builds these has to be entirely different than a steel body shop.
Yeah.
It's riveted and screwed together, and they're very thick gauge metals, very different than the welding of steel. So it's the commitment to doing it.
Exactly. I was talking about that, like the commitment, the investment, the money behind a product like this, which is the most important product for a former company.
Yeah. You know what? It was a decision that was almost made clear, because if you do this on a car, like you were just saying, the car gets better acceleration, better braking, better handling. Always important for a car, but a car is not a tool. When you can do all of that in a truck, you get fantastic driving. But if you can take 700 pounds out of the truck and then put another and put all of that weight back in the bed, or you can put even more than that, increase your towing by 1,000 pounds, because what you're doing is you're lightweighting the body, but you're keeping the brakes, the powertrains, the cooling system all the same. This is a truck that does more work. And when we realized it's not just about efficiency, it's not about handling, it's about doing more work, this seemed like the logical vehicle to be first for Ford Motor Company.
Yeah, and then all the other things that are in this truck, I mean, again, I'm not going to waste more time saying it, but like, there are like so many things, so many technologies, so many little details. I mean, we just walk around one of them, and like cameras, LED lighting, and the idea on the side mirrors to have an LED lamp there. I mean, like so many little things that are fantastic. I mean, Some people expect a pickup truck is like a box with a wheel.
Yeah. No, you're exactly right. And the exciting thing for us is we get all of these ideas from our customers. Our customers tell us they want to see all around the vehicle, which implies they want cameras everywhere. They put lighting in the box, and it was a customer who came up and said, I'd love to have a light in my front pillar like a police car where I can drive down the road and spin it sideways. Yeah. Well, you can't do that legally.
Exactly.
And it'd be ugly and it wouldn't be good for aerodynamics. But then one of our engineers said, hey, we can put lights at the end of the mirrors that you can turn on in the cab and can light up the whole side of the vehicle, whether you're at a campsite or a work site. And that was the aha moment. But we got the idea from the customer. Customers have never stopped giving us better ideas for the truck. And leaders go work at figuring out how to put them in there. And that's the F-150 team at Ford.
Yeah. Let's talk about a little bit about the engines. We're seeing two of them here, but there's four variants, right?
Yeah, four engines, starting at the 3.5 naturally aspirated, up to an all-new 2.7 EcoBoost, which just has great horsepower at 325, great torque, 375. That's designed for the guy we want to bring back to full-size pickup who says, I've left you guys. All you care about is big V8s and big towing and hauling. So that's a great new engine, slots right in the white space. And, of course, we have our proven 5-liter and then the big daddy, the 3.5-liter EcoBoost. So now we've got two EcoBoosts. EcoBoost is twin turbine, direct injection. Unbelievable torque, unbelievable performance with great fuel economy.
Yeah. And then you get into the cabin, and then you get into a first-class airplane.
Yeah. Well, thank you for that.
Because screens, cameras.
Full-size pickups are fun. They're wide vehicles. We have the full-size cab, which is front-row seating and rear seating with a lot of leg room. And when you get all of that space, make it as accommodating, easy to see out of, and put in all the features and the luxuries you can. We span it. You can still get a crew cab that's, sold as a fleet vehicle.
Yeah.
Cloth seats, absolutely.
Yeah, of course.
But we can really have a blast and really have fun at Ford when you dress up that space. We're not dressing up a shrunken space. It's a big space. Go big in the big space.
Yeah. And talking about going big in a big space, this space in the automotive industry is like the most important. I mean, starting with the F-150, there's the Chevy and the Toyotas and all the cars, Dodge with the Ram.
Yeah.
But Ford has been 37 years the number one car.
Yeah.
I mean, how much of a challenge was there for you to be in charge of this project?
Well, it was exciting and a bit challenging. The confidence I had is I've spent 16 years working on F-Series. And if you look back, the F-Series team at Ford typically stays in place for a long time. I've been at Ford 28 years. I've spent time, almost all of the 28 years, on truck. And so, yeah, it's challenging. There's pressure. It's nerve-wracking. But I had enough training from all of the people who taught me how to do this and all of the customer interface to go in and say, yeah, I know how to do this. And in fact, the team around me, if I were to die tomorrow, knows how to do it without me anyway.
Yeah.
Ford's F-Series is a team. I'm lucky to lead it. They could do it without me.
Yeah, but it's another very impressive thing. Every time I go to a car launch and all that, talking about how many people work in these things.
Well, at any given moment, you get hundreds and hundreds of engineers. So at the beginning of the program, you might have 50 assigned to just start laying out the basics. About the middle of the program, there's 700-800 engineers working on all the different things, whether it's the body panels, the frame, wheels and tires, or all of the technologies you talked about. You have safety engineers, as a blizzard. And then as you get down to where we are now, where we're getting ready to start running these through the assembly plant, you're back down to 100 engineers, trucks designed. We're sitting there with the manufacturing engineers getting ready to roll these out at one a minute.
Yeah, one a minute. Yeah, yeah. But when you sell that many, that's,
I know,
that's a rate. And how, to that point, how does Ford does it? I mean, it's like more production plants where they build it, or why they're selling, how can you sell so many?
Well,
how many a month? Like, it's like one a minute. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know the math.
One every 42 seconds. I forget. As we're talking here, our monthly numbers, to be honest with you, 60,000 a month.
Yeah, exactly, something like that.
Some months higher than that. We've got two assembly plants that we run round the clock 7 days a week, which I think is 22 hours of production time. And we just make maximum efficiency of our assembly line. There's a whole story there, and there's a whole story with the body shop and the changeover. That's wonderful. But it is. It is a big commitment. And what sells this many is the customers want to buy them.
Yeah.
Just because we make them doesn't mean they can go out the door. They want to buy
them. And again, there's
many.
Competition also, and some people will like it, but you have also very loyal customers, right?
Yeah. Oh, Ford truckers, truck customers are extremely loyal. We know that, and that, you know, that motivates the product team. Every time we work on a truck feature, whether it's a small feature or a big changeover, we're like, what is the customer expecting, and how can I make it even better than the last truck he bought? Absolutely.
Yeah, and for the development of this one, we only have 1 minute, so I'm sorry for that. But you actually talked to a lot of them and, like, did testing with them.
Yeah, we took out trucks that we built. We took early trucks, 2009 model year trucks, and we made them entirely out of aluminum, and we put people in those trucks. We took
Without telling me what it was,
yeah, we
right?
took a set of 2011 trucks and actually made the boxes out of aluminum and put them in service and didn't tell them about it. And these were fleets that really punished the truck. And they came back and they loved it and they loved the idea. And we learned from them. We learned where to upgauge. We learned how to make it stronger. But yeah, we've had a lot of test trucks on the road that look just like today's truck, but are actually made out of aluminum.
Well, Pete Reyes, the chief program engineer for the Ford F-150, thank you very much for your time and also for your presentation. I really enjoy it. Most of the time, engineers are like, I'm serious and all that. You have like great personality. It really shows that you enjoy your job.
Javier, thank you, and thank you for the interview. This
thank
is wonderful.
You. Bye.
Y no se vayan, que cuando regresemos tenemos más de la presentación de la nueva pickup truck Ford F-150 2015, a la cual asistimos allá en San Antonio, en Texas. Yo soy Javier Mota y esto es Auto 060.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.